Hello everyone, welcome back to Simplified Research Method series. This is part 3, Critical Literature Review, how to write a critical literature review. In earlier two parts, part 1 and part 2, we talked about how to write your abstract, introduction, your project definition, and the background of the study. So this time we are going to talk about how to write critical literature review. So for a critical literature review, you always search for the articles or documents or the relevant views based on the title or based on your subject area. Then you read, after searching the documents, then you read the documents. After reading, you are supposed to quote the documents. Quoting, for example, whichever paragraph or whichever sentence is relevant for your argument, you highlight that and make a note of it. So once you make a note of it, after that you are going to paraphrase, and after paraphrasing, you supposed to cite the document, or you're supposed to cite the argument with the author's name and the year of the publication. And after that, you are going to check the document that for relevance, that the view you are talking about, it is the same view that other authors have given. So let's talk about, if for example you find three articles which are relevant with your argument you are making, so what you are going to do with those three articles. So let's say out of, you search for 10 articles, out of 10, three articles were the most appropriate or most relevant with the argument you are making on your literature review. So this example is a simplified example, what you are going to do in that. So article one, you are going to read, you are going to code, you are going to make notes, paraphrase, check and cite. Same thing you are going to do for article two. You are going to read, code, note, paraphrase, check and cite, and the same for article three. So once you have paraphrased the views of these three authors from three different articles, you are going to do the cross case analysis, the cross analysis between one and two. So article one and article two, what article one says about, if the views of article two are similar or different. So you will be looking at the similarity of different opinions between the two authors. Then the same thing you are going to do between the article two or article three, or article one, sorry, author two and author three. So you are going to do the same thing. You are going to read, code, note, paraphrase, check and cite, and then you are going to do cross analysis between the two different views or two similar views. So as an example, author one, they talked about that implementing lean in construction process will improve the flow of communication. The article two says that to improve the flow of communication, all the construction supply chain members or supply chain organizations need to come together and act on one goal, which is the flow of communication. So and then article three also talk about, yes, the implementing lean would enhance or would advance the flow of communication in construction processes. So in that so article one and article three are giving the same view, but article two, the author of article two, is giving you the additional information that implementing lean to advance the construction process not just required lean implementation, but all these organizations involved in construction supply chain need to come together, and that is the conclusion. So you are going to look at what article one is talking about, what article two is talking about, what article three is talking about, what are the similarities or what are the differences between them. You can also criticize the articles, their methodology, what are their methodology, what were the limitations, or how relevant the findings from those articles are. And then you are going to look at the third one, which is the article one and article three, the views between the article one and article three. So you are looking at three different views, three cross analysis between article one, article two, number one, between article two and article three is number two, or between article one and article three is number three. So or put it like that, A, B, and C. So three different views, three different analyses, and then you are going to give a final, which is the final analysis bit of all these three articles, and discuss about the agreement or disagreement, and then conclude the main finding, check, and cite as well. So this is how you are going to do critical literature review. So you are looking at the different arguments, different views between the authors, and then you coming up with your own view. So that makes it critical analysis, but at the same time you can criticize the limitations of those of the findings, or maybe one of the article one is limited to within the West Midland area. So article 2 talked about somewhere in Saudi Arabia. Article 3 is a research about USA. So in the USA, this is what they're talking about. In Saudi Arabia, this is what they're talking about. In West Midland, in UK, that is what they're talking about. So you can do the analysis. So what are the limitations? Now, these three articles are from three different countries. Now you have to look at your inclusion and exclusion criteria, which articles you are going to include or which articles you are going to exclude for your analysis. So if your, let's say, if your research is restricted to West Midland, UK, or restricted to England, then you should be taking articles from England, which, or the research which talks about the England, or if you're taking articles from any other country or any other region, then you should be looking for that art, that the research has the similar environment, or the scope of the research is same as well. So there are few things which you can consider, but that was a very simplified example of writing a critical literature review. It becomes much more complicated when the numbers of article increase, but when you talk about at least one argument, I would suggest that you should take at least 3 to 5, you should read 3 to 5 different articles or different books, and come up with one argument or one conclusion. So thank you very much for watching this video. On next video, we are going to talk about the case study analysis. This is the series of Simplified Research Method. And thank you very much, and see you soon. Bye-bye.